like it. Do you remember what it was? Yes, it was manger. Manger. You also learned to work. Yes, it's you are correct. To work in French is travailler. Travailler. So today I wanted to go a little further and see some sentences. Donc aujourd'hui, je voulais aller un petit peu plus loin et t'apprendre quelques phrases. Each time I will say a sentence in English, I will also say it in French right after. À chaque fois que je vais dire une phrase en anglais, je vais la traduire immédiatement après en français. So, even if you don't understand my French, you will hear the translation each time and catch a few words. Donc, même si tu ne comprends pas la traduction à chaque fois, eh bien, tu vas entendre cette traduction et sûrement apprendre petit à petit quelques mots. So, I will also write some sentences on this paper and translate it for you, of course. Donc, je vais aussi écrire quelques phrases sur cette feuille de papier et te les traduire juste après, bien évidemment. Donc, on va commencer. So, let's start with... and French fries is des frites, because when there is many of something, you will desire, you will show them in your sentence with des, because there is a lot of them. There is many of them, at least two. Donc, ce qu'il se passe, c'est que tu as plusieurs frites. Et donc, c'est pour ça qu'il faut rajouter des, car il y en a plusieurs. If there was only one French fry, you would have said, je mange une frite. Je mange une frite. Because une is the singular, but you have to put before frite. So I eat one French fry. Je mange une frite. I eat French fries. Je mange des frites. Okay. Great. So, before we continue, I just wanted to learn you two new words. Avant de continuer, je voulais t'apprendre deux nouveaux mots. The first one is left. So, left in French is gauche. Left is gauche. Gauche, gauche, gauche. And the other one is right. And in French, you can say it droite. Right is droite. 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 We can move on now. Tu es d'accord? On peut donc continuer. Je suis means that you are something, and you are not the verb to pick. You can be defined by picking. This is not what you are. So in French you will say je prends. I will make a little correction for the next. Je vais corriger la fin de ma phrase. So in French, there is a lot of words which sound exactly the same as vers. Donc, en français, il y a énormément de mots qui se prononcent vers. There is the glass, which is translated by le vers. The glass, le verre, written like this, écrit comme ceci. But there is also the green color, which is le verre. You pronounce it exactly the same, but you write it with a T instead of an R and an E. Il y a donc aussi la couleur verte que l'on écrit le vert, mais avec un T et non pas un R et un E. And there is a few other words, but you have to pronounce vert. But I will not explain all of them because there are not a lot. They are not very useful for you. Alors, il y a aussi d'autres mots qui se prononcent vers, mais je ne vais pas tous te les expliquer, car il y en a beaucoup et qui ne servent pas forcément. So, let's go back to our sentence. I'm picking. The glass, le verre. It's right now, it's easy. Je prends le verre. And which is on the left. So, donc, je prends le verre. Qui est ta gauche? I will write it for you. Je vais gauche, which is translated by qi. But it's not always the case. Sometimes when you say who is it, you will say in French qui est. Qui is most of the time used to designate someone, but in this case you want to link an object and a location, so you use qui. Donc, which est traduit par qui. Ce n'est pas toujours le cas. En général, qui est utilisé pour parler d'une personne. Qui est-il? Who is it? Mais dans ce cas, là, tu veux relier un objet à un emplacement, et du coup on utilise le qui. Which qui is est to be in French is être. Je suis, tu es, il est, nous sommes, vous êtes, ils sont. So here you are talking about an object, so you use il est. Qui est? You don't have to say again il, because you are already talking about the class. Le verre qui est? On the left, à gauche. On the left, à gauche. I hope it's clear enough. J'espère que c'est suffisamment clair. Donc, on va désormais voir une dernière phrase. So, we will see a last sentence. Simple one. Where is Brian? Donc, une phrase très simple. Where is Brian? So, where in French is où? Où? The third person of singular. Brian est à la troisième personne du singulier. Because you are not talking about yourself. You are not talking about the person in front of you. You are talking about Brian, who is someone else, but a single person. So you use il est. Is. Petites leçons peuvent t'aider. See you soon.